So you hear it all the time, make money in real estate with no money down. Is this real or is it just something that people say on the internet? In this video, I'm going to share the real truth about getting started as a real estate investor with no money. I'm going to share with you basically 7 financing strategies that do in fact make it possible for anyone to buy investment property without much of their own money to begin with. And at the very end, I'll share a bonus strategy plus a real use case study of an investor who actually pulled this off and bought 16 units with almost no money out of his pocket. So let's get right into it. Whenever you hear people talking about no money down strategies, they're usually referring to creative financing. These are sources of capital that are not using traditional banks. Most people don't understand that there are legitimate financing alternatives other than going to a traditional bank and then filling out an application and putting down 20-25% down. This obviously requires a big chunk of change and you have to play by the bank's rules. So we're going to talk about how you can capitalize on what you do possess, which is time, effort, energy, and your connections. You'll use these available resources to deploy our weapons of mass production. These are real strategies that you can use to break into the real estate investing game. Among this arsenal, there are 7 alternative financing options that you can deploy. Our first and favorite weapon is seller financing. This is when the property owner agrees to sell you the property and receive the balance in payments over time. There's often an initial down payment and the monthly payments for the remaining balance. You might wonder why a seller would do this instead of getting all the cash up front. They already have ownership of the property. Selling it to you allows them to generate income without the hassle of managing it themselves, thereby creating a win-win situation, especially if the property needs a lot of updating or there's been management that hasn't been going well. You can improve the management as the buyer. Additionally, it can help the owner lower their tax burden by taking their equity and taking it over installments over time. One drawback of seller financing is that not every seller is willing to do this. Some want all their cash to buy the next property or do a 1031 exchange. Others won't do it simply because they don't understand it. Even if it would be a good deal for them, a confused mind says no. So you'll have to do a lot of the work in hunting around to find the right owner that is willing to do seller financing. The next weapon at your disposal is taking over the existing financing. In commercial real estate, it's not uncommon for the lender to allow the existing financing to be assumed. You can step in the place of the current borrower. The only catch with this strategy is that you have to qualify through the lender, through the traditional bank process. So you'll need to have good credit and have some experience in the business before will really help. But don't forget that this is a legitimate option, as in many cases, you can buy a property and take over the existing financing, which is sometimes much better than the available market terms. Now, the third weapon is buying a property subject to the existing mortgage. This is much different than the loan assumption. With subject to investing, the existing mortgage remains in place. So the loan is still in the previous owner's name and you take over their payments. And to be very candid, this is kind of a sneaky strategy. If the lender finds out someone else bought the property, they have a legitimate legal right to accelerate the loan all at once, making the whole amount due at once. So tread lightly when using the strategy. I often hear gurus talking about this in a very cavalier way, touting it as this amazing, clever strategy with no downside. Well, it is an amazing strategy, but it does have downsides. I've bought personally tons of properties subject to the existing mortgage using this strategy. I've currently never had a bank call a loan due, but I know investors who have. I also have had sellers who have years later decided that they didn't like the situation that we negotiated and demanded that I pay off the mortgage. So do your homework on the strategy and tread lightly. So let's move on to the fourth weapon, which is doing a master lease. In its simplest form, a master lease is a lease that allows you to sublet the property. So when you do a master lease, you're not actually buying the property. You're leasing the property. You're offering to lease the property and manage the tenants, effectively a management strategy that doesn't require any cash out of your own pocket. Instead, you're offering time, energy, and your expertise as a manager to better manage the property. This is very common in commercial properties, which is why we talk about this so much on this channel. A commercial master lease is an excellent way to get started in this business as it allows you to use what you have, and that is time. You don't have a lot of money, you do have time. Commercial master lease is the natural choice. Now, the next 3 strategies involve partnering up with someone else who does have capital. This could be a friend, a family member, a private investor who sees the potential in these creative ideas that you have and is willing to provide the capital to make it happen. The great thing about partnering up is that it allows you to bring what you do have, which is skills and expertise, to the table while still getting a piece of the action. So maybe you're the one who finds a deal, decides to manage the property, and then oversees the renovations, while your financial partner brings the financial horsepower. It's a symbiotic relationship that can be incredibly powerful when done well. The next weapon of mass production is using private lenders. When you find and negotiate a good deal but lack cash in your own back pocket, sometimes you can raise money from a private lender. This is usually an individual person, someone you already know or recently met but established a relationship, and offer them a chance to earn return on their capital if they helped buy the deal for you. You use their capital to purchase the property and you give them a promissory note detailing those payment terms in the promissory note. They get a mortgage or a lien against the property as security. And this is very similar, in fact, identical to the structure that you would use with a traditional bank. But in this case, it's with a private party instead of a bank. And the catch here is that you have to go and find this private lender yourself, as they typically don't advertise like a bank would. And you may have to go and educate them on how the process works. Another way to jump into real estate investing without having your own cash is to then team up and find a partner who does have the funds. This is very similar to the private lender strategy, but with a joint venture partner, your actual partners in the deal together. So you don't owe the interest on their money. You pay them from the cash flow and equity that's in the deal you buy together. This offers a higher return for the JV partner, but offers them far less security than a private lender. I usually think of this as you being the catalyst who found the deal and structured everything, and you do most of the work, while the financial partner is your joint venture and you refer to them as the financier. And there could also be several parties in the JV agreement, but this is usually an agreement to work out on a specific deal and you have an existing relationship with the parties. You'll definitely want to hire the services of a lawyer to set up this JV agreement properly. And the final strategy we'll discuss in your arsenal is a partnership. This is where you create a business together with somebody else. Usually you're joining forces and establishing an entity like an LLC together with your partners. And again, in this instance where you don't have much cash, you're bringing the hustle and they're deploying their capital. You may need to do several deals together in the structure, or you could create a new entity on a per deal basis, depending on the details of the situation. The distinction here is that you're going into business with someone. This is not a one-off scenario like in the previous JV agreement. You're forming an entity together to do some real estate deals. And you can probably already tell there's some overlap, and the distinction is really just in the paperwork. That's where you'll hire a consultant, an attorney, maybe even a CPA, or a combination of all three, because you really want to get that paperwork right. Okay, now let's pull this all together. I promised you a bonus strategy and a case study of a zero money down deal that one of our clients did. Well, this is actually a perfect two-for-one scenario. Our client used this bonus technique to get a zero down deal. The bonus strategy is a loan stacking strategy. And what this means is using two or more financing strategies right on top of each other. This is best explained with an example. So our client, we'll call him Barney, bought a property in Mississippi. It's a 16-unit multifamily apartment complex. He used a technique we call call five, write five, and he negotiated owner financing and got a 75% traditional bank loan. So we did the bonus strategy we call loan stacking. He used two different financing tools. One is a 75% loan to value loan, and the seller financed the remaining 25%. He brought less than $3,000 down at closing. And then when he closed, he had almost no money down in the deal. And at closing, he received the first month's rent of about $8,800 the day after. So is that a deal that you would do? These kind of deals really can happen, but it takes a lot of hunting around to find the right situations. You won't find many of these type of deals that are listed on the Crexie or MLS or Zillow. So are you ready to dive in the world of commercial real estate investing? You can subscribe to the channel and learn how to invest in the pros. So the great thing about commercial real estate is that you're just one deal away from completely changing your life. So join us in the One Deal and Done Summit. Check out the link below.